In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect a Lambda function to an SNS topic using an SQS queue. While you can also directly connect SNS to a Lambda function, as we did in the previous episode, there can be situations where you want to decouple the two. For example, when a Lambda function can only handle a certain amount of messages at a time because it's communicating with a legacy backend that can't take too much load. Or even worse, that legacy backend is so unpredictable that it crashes every now and then and a message needs to be processed again. All this and more can be done by adding an SQS queue between SNS and the Lambda function, which can hold messages until they're ready to be picked up and handle retries whenever a downstream process fails. We're already in the SNS dashboard in the AWS Management Console, and as you can see, we have our topic called Events. Let's open the topic and have a look at its subscriptions. Currently, there's one subscriber, and it's a Lambda function representing our fulfillment service. So whenever there's a new message on the topic, it will immediately be sent to this function. Let's have a look at the function itself. I'm going to open up the Lambda dashboard, and here's our function. There's some important information here. The function seems to be using a legacy backend, which only accepts one message at a time, and it also randomly fails. Let's try this in practice. Right here, I have a small Python script that puts three messages on the topic. It first creates a resource representing the topic using BODO3, the AWS SDK for Python, and then it quickly publishes three messages to the topic. Let's run the function, sending message 1, 2, and 3. Now, all these messages should have been forwarded to the Lambda function, which then tried to process them using the legacy backend. Let's have a look at the function log. Right here, we can see that one message failed, probably message 2, because both message 1 and 3 have successfully been processed. The way our architecture is currently set up, message 2 has been lost. We could now build a lot of failure handling and retry logic ourselves, but it's much easier to just plug an SQS queue between SNS and the Lambda function. Let's open the SQS dashboard, navigate to Queues, and create a new queue. We're going to choose a standard queue, give it a name, leave all the defaults as they are, and click on Create Queue. Now we can directly subscribe this queue to the Amazon SNS topic. Choose the events topic and click on Save. Also, here's the ARN, the Amazon resource name, which we will need in a later step. I'm going to go back to the topic, have a look at the subscriptions. You can now see both the Lambda and the SQS subscription, and disconnect the Lambda function by deleting the subscription. Next, to connect everything, the Lambda function needs a new trigger. The old one can be deleted, and by clicking on Add Trigger, we can set up a new one. Choose SQS, select our fulfillment service queue, set the batch size to 1. Remember, the legacy backend can only handle one message at a time. Scroll down and click Add. This will display an error, which is expected. Remember, by default, everything in AWS cannot do anything before getting explicit permissions. So we need to allow the Lambda function to do a few things in order to receive messages from our queue. Let's cancel this real quick and go to permissions. The execution role contains all the permissions for this Lambda function. Let's open it up and create a new inline policy. Our function should be able to access SQS and to execute certain actions. To keep everything secure, I'm not going to give it general access to all actions, but I'm going to limit it to these three API calls. Get queue attributes, receive message, and delete message, which it will call whenever it has successfully processed a message. I'm also going to restrict these permissions to our fulfillment service queue by adding the ARN. Remember, that's what we find in the details sections of the SQS queue. Copy, paste, add, and review policy. I like to give my policies very descriptive names. Can receive messages from fulfillment queue, and click on Create Policy. Now let's go back to the Lambda function and try adding this trigger again. Add trigger, choose SQS, our fulfillment service queue, a batch size of 1, and click on Add. With the correct permissions, everything has been set up and we can go back and try sending our messages again. Let's have a look at the function log again. And we can see that this time only message 3 has succeeded and messages 1 and 2 have failed. Now let's click on Resume and see what happens. After a few seconds, there was another error, but now message 2 has been processed too. And it will automatically retry message 1 until it has also been processed. It took a number of retries, but ultimately all messages, message 1, message 2, and message 3 have successfully been delivered. And this is how you can set up an SQS queue as a buffer, throttle, or automatic retry mechanism between an SNS topic and a Lambda function. In the next video, I'm going to show you how you can control who may subscribe to your topic. Please drop a like and subscribe so you get notified when that video comes out.